Denver Broncos Mile High View.
No commercials, no bullshit.
So, I realize that it's the season of Kool-Aid. It's time of year where every team, all 32 teams, are going to the Super Bowl. No doubt about it. And this subject is along those lines of Denver Broncos having the, you know, the 2015. They're bringing the 2015 defense to the NFL this year. I was listening to sports talk radio. Of course, the Kool-Aid is, you know, the Kool-Aid drinkers are all baffled. They're baffled how the national sports talk, sports media, how they possibly couldn't put the Denver Broncos in the top 10. But it was even worse than that. They couldn't understand why the Denver Broncos weren't in the top 5. Okay. We got to knock off the nonsense. You know, the whole reason you get Vic Fangio in is that the defense has been slowly crumbling. Okay. And there's still problems with the defense already. There's still problems. Linebacking is an issue, and my opinion is the defensive line, there's questions, in my opinion. Questions with, you know, the middle of that. Some of those questions could be answered from a pass rush standpoint. You can bring Chubb in the middle, which was pretty effective. It was about the only time they really were effective in the middle. But the biggest question that isn't ever asked in Kool-Aid country for the Denver Broncos is run stop. Before I say they're the number 10, the number 5, you know, it's always possible they could be become the number 5. And one other thing, too, is you have to, as a, you know, a listener, I know it's great that you get your little brain massaged with, you know, nice Kool-Aid of, you know, DBs dancing in the end zone, you know, with footballs in their hands, like sugar plums. But reality is every year defensively teams fluctuate. You know, who goes up, who goes down. It's always a fluctuation for a lot of different reasons. Schedules, injuries, you know, you name it. But I think going to keep harping on this is that I think the test for the Broncos as to whether what kind of a defense they will be more in the running game. You know, are they able to, well, mainly in the running game, but you know, when it comes to their linebacking, you know, here's the thing too, the Broncos were constantly exploited by tight ends, and that's what made them not such a great defense. They were constantly getting exploited. That I would stick, if I was an opposing team, I would stick with that game plan with the Denver Broncos. Now, unfortunately, preseason, even when the starters are all out, it's hard to gauge. Let's say the defensive line isn't doing so great at stopping the run. Well, defensive lines really only go at about half speeds, all of them, during preseason, three-quarter speed, but they're not going full speed. So from that point of view, it's not going to be. But maybe from a linebacking sense, you can see if they're getting exploited by tight ends, their linebacking, or even slot receivers as well. So the real test is going to be, I believe, with the Raiders as far as the run game goes. I would bet that Gruden, if he's a coach worth his salt, they're going to test the Broncos' run stop ability. And again, you heard nobody in sports talk radio even remotely discuss how well they're going to be against run stop. So, you know, I believe that the Broncos could be an upper third defense. You know, that'd be 10, 11. That's believable. But, you know, if they get exploited in the running game and get exploited in the middle, they may not be. You know, I know they got Vic Fangio, but again, you know, this is their first year. They don't have all their players in. You know, you got to remember that. So let's just kind of keep a perspective on this. You know, Denver doesn't, if they're not bringing their 2015 defense, they're just not. You know, but, you know, can they be a top, you know, one of the top third defenses? And also, you know, what else is going to play into all of this, too, is the offense. And special teams. You know, if the special teams is screwing up, and I brought this up in my special teams edition, you know, these are the things you got to hold into account. You can't just look at the players themselves. You got to look at also what, and this is how, why defenses fluctuate. You know, they could have outstanding year for special teams and they give the defense a really good advantage. You know, so there's so many factors when it comes to defense. Just to anoint in a Kool-Aid drinking way the Denver Broncos with being, you know, the 2015 top five defense, all this nonsense, you know, you got to stop falling for it so that when it doesn't happen, you're not like in this shock of disbelief and want everybody fired. You know, you got to look at it perspectively.